Moustafa, settled here after growing up in Sudan. Good to see you both. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you so much.
Let's start with your personal story. So, Paulina, you left Poland to come here. What was the decision at the time?
So I left Poland as a teenager. I went to a German-speaking school in Poland, and then I transferred to Germany. And at that point in time, I knew I want to continue, learn more, see more of the world, and learn more languages. So I moved over to the UK. I was lucky enough to start to live in Oxford, and got embraced by the international community. And later on, I moved to London, where I live currently, and really enjoy being part of the community and this international scene that we have here.
Okay, and Nagla, again, you spent lots of time in lots of different countries, but eventually have come to the UK. What was your journey?
My journey started in Rome. I was born in Rome, Italy, then moved to Sudan. I grew up in Sudan. I was educated in Sudan. I got until master's degree in Sudan. Then I wanted to explore my chances in other countries. So I immigrated to United Arab Emirates. I worked there for 3 years as a journalist and a translator. And then I came back to study, and I started putting up a proposal for PhD, and I applied to many universities, and I got an acceptance from York University. That's 20 years ago. And then I was very happy. So I came here, I came to London, and with the purpose of studying for PhD degree. But after a few weeks, it appeared to me that it's very difficult, because it was I'm going towards private tuition, and financially it was difficult. So I fell in love with London. I wanted to stay, but I have to go to work. So I worked for Sainsbury for 4 years. I worked for Westminster Mind for 11 years. I worked for many places, project coordinator, development officer. Then finally, I decided to work for myself.
To run your own firm. Paulina, that's very similar to what you've done. But actually, the story there is quite interesting in terms of actually very skilled workers coming to the UK to
Absolutely.
Live here. But what you've noticed is actually quite a lot of them are struggling to make the leap from
Absolutely.
Lower paid work to actually being used in what they can do. Why is that?
Well, there are several barriers. You know, imagine people coming over here who struggle with their English at first. With time, they start to feel more comfortable with their English. However, they have a career gap on their CV, because normally they have to take some survival jobs. So the people that we work at On Part 2, the social enterprise that I run, normally work as nannies and cleaners and baristas and waitresses. And unfortunately, the current system, the recruitment system, doesn't quite work, because the minute someone, an employer, recruiter, sees that you have several years of a career gap, they feel that you potentially already your skills are outdated, or potentially they may feel that they don't recognize the name of the organizations you worked for.
Yeah.
So these are the challenges that these people have. And I feel that there is a huge opportunity there. We can work together on bringing this talent to the forefront and building bridging programs that allow these people to really put their skills to use.
Paulina, Nagla, we are out of time, but you know, good to see that we are celebrating International Migrants Day today.
Thank
and two strong stories of people who've made the UK their home.
Yes, we are running our own businesses now.
Fantastic. There we go. Right, time for a short break, still to come.